Shebumpkin goldfish info and care. Unique colorization and social behavior make Shebumpkin goldfish a popular choice for freshwater aquariums. This fancy goldfish breed belongs to the family Cyprinidae, which also includes carps, chubs, and minnows. Welcome to our channel. In today's video, we will be taking a look at the Shebumpkin goldfish. But before I begin, be sure to hit that like button. It lets me know that you're enjoying videos like this. Meet the Shebumpkin goldfish. Shebumpkin goldfish are classified as Carassius erratus. They are sometimes referred to as calico goldfish because of their molted color patterns, which can be made of a wide variety of colors. What makes them unique from other goldfish is the blue hue to their background color, which is very rare in a goldfish. Some history. Wild goldfish, Carassius erratus, are subtropical fish found in Central Asia and China. They live in stagnant to slow-moving waters in lakes and rivers. The Shebumpkin goldfish, along with other varieties of pet goldfish, are not identified as threatened or endangered. They have been captive bred for many generations and are not found in the wild. Tank setup. A comfortable environment for Shebumpkin goldfish starts with the tank. Experts on Shebumpkin goldfish recommend setting up your tank with the following: dechlorinated water, normalized for temperature for 24 hours, biological filtration, tank thermometer, a lid for the tank to avoid evaporation, a circulating pump, siphoning tube to remove debris. Lighting may be necessary if you have live plants. These items will help keep the environment clean and aerated, which are requirements for healthy fish. Shebumpkin goldfish can thrive in a variety of conditions, but do best in a tank with fewer plants, real or artificial, as they tend to uproot them in search of food. They are hardy eaters and will eat from the surface as well as foraging through the substrate, so any medium-sized substrate is appropriate. They also produce more waste than other types of fish, so biological filtration is preferred. Rocks and other structures in the tank should be short and smooth to protect their flowy fins. Tank size. Shebumpkin goldfish tolerate cold water well, even just a few degrees above freezing, so they would do well in a roomy outdoor pond. If you plan to keep them in an indoor aquarium, a 20-gallon tank is a minimum size for one fish. As a general rule, allow 20 gallons per Shebumpkin goldfish because they are active swimmers and grow quickly. Experts agree that while it is possible to stunt their size by keeping them in a smaller tank, this does cause health issues. Shebumpkins also consume more oxygen than most fish their size and would benefit from a tank that provides a maximum amount of water surface area, such as a longer tank rather than a taller tank. Water parameters. Water quality is important to the health of your fish, and Shebumpkin goldfish will tolerate a wide range, but in general, aim for these parameters. Temperature, 65 to 72 degrees Fahrenheit. pH, 6 to 8. Hardness, 5 to 19 DGH. Nitrates, 0 ppm. Ammonia, 0 ppm. Test water monthly for pH, nitrates, and ammonia. Any traces of nitrates or ammonia could indicate dirty water due to waste or byproducts. Clean the tank, structures, and floor regularly, and replace 1/4 of the water weekly with fresh, dechlorinated water. The three types of Shebumpkins. Within the Shebumpkin breed, there are three distinct varieties: American, also called Japanese, Bristol, and London. They are mainly differentiated by their tail shape. American Shebumpkins have a long, pointed tail fin with a deep fork. Bristol Shebumpkins have a large, full tail fin. London Shebumpkins have a shorter, rounder tail fin. Shebumpkin versus Comet Goldfish. Shebumpkin goldfish and Comet Goldfish look very similar, and it can be difficult to differentiate these two species. Both are fancy goldfish with long, flowy fins and forked tails, and both come in a variety of color combinations. Shabumkins, however, have a unique combination of scales that make them appear pearlescent. They also have some blue in their background color. Shabumkin diet. As with most aquarium fish, owners should be cautious of overfeeding. Feed them what they can eat within 2 minutes, twice a day. Shabumkin goldfish are ferocious eaters and have been known to steal food from other fish. If you have shyer fish in the tank, make sure they get enough to eat. They are omnivores and can get a quality diet from flake food and occasionally brine shrimp, bloodworms, tubifex, and vegetables. Tank mates for shabumkins. Shabumkin goldfish are peaceful and social and will get along well with most peaceful fish. They are active swimmers and scavengers, so other scavenging fish may not be necessary. They may steal food from other fish, so use caution if housing them with shyer tank mates. Some species that are good options as tank mates are cherry barbs, glass catfish, ornamental minnows, white cloud minnow, and zebra fish. Shabumkin lifespan. Healthy shabumkin goldfish can live up to 20 years and grow to 18 inches in a pond, or up to 12 inches and 15 years in a well-maintained tank. Breeding shabumkin. Shabumkin goldfish are moderately easy to breed. Use a spawning tank with plenty of plants, real or artificial. Slowly cool the water to about 60 degrees Fahrenheit. Then slowly raise the temperature to about 72 degrees Fahrenheit. The increase in temperature will trigger them to spawn. Females can produce thousands of eggs, but after spawning, the adults will usually eat the eggs, so it is recommended to remove them from the spawning tank. Eggs will hatch in about 7 days, and the fry will need to be fed small foods or fry diet until they are large enough to eat a regular goldfish diet. They may join the adult tank when they are at least 1 inch. Summary. Shabumkin goldfish are active, beautiful, and hardy fish that tolerate a wide range of conditions. They are also very social and would be welcomed by a variety of tank mates. Use caution with shyer fish at feeding times, as shabumkins may steal food. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to hit the like button and leave a comment. And I'll see you in the next video.